Not a dress rehearsal, not even a proper first draft. But these are the scenes, leaders meeting, diplomats haggling, that will eventually accompany any peace deal.
We are at a war, and we don't have time for prolonged work. Moving to peace means acting fast. And when every step is worked out, the path will be opened for the second peace summit, and thus for ending this war.
There is a very long way to go. One of today's tiny steps was this international group calling the conflict a war for the first time. But 80 countries called for the territorial integrity of Ukraine to be the basis for any peace agreement to end Russia's war. Some countries who attended the conference, including India and Saudi Arabia, did not endorse that final statement, however. And all of this can only be academic when Russia, the belligerent, was absent, uninvited. China, very much invited, and who many hope will eventually bring Russia to a table like this, was also missing.
One key question remains. How and when can Russia be included in the process? We have heard it in many of your statements. A lasting solution must involve both parties.
All the while, of course, Russia continues to bombard Ukraine. The latest from Moscow was that Putin was not ruling out talks, but wants unspecified guarantees. Russia's position is that Ukraine should give up the four regions Russia declared it had annexed in 2022, so it remains a meaningless offer. And Ukraine demands that Russian troops leave its territory and that its borders with Russia, including Crimea, are restored. The details of a text may eventually be drawn up in a place like this. Fountain pens exchanged, treaties signed. But peace won't be decided here in the green rolling hills. It will be fought for and died for in the trenches of Ukraine. Tom Cheshire, Sky News.